is Dr. Nitin Jain, and I'm speaking to you about my JBJS article, Comparative Time to Improvement in Nonoperative and Operative Treatment of Rotator Cuff Tears. We did this research after feedback from both patients and clinicians. Patients often wonder what their timeline for recovery looks like and how it would be different for operative versus non-operative treatments. Patients do well after both operative and non-operative treatments for cuff tears, and hence this question is central to their choosing of which treatment path they wish to pursue. Based on their life situations or based on their job, they might need to get to work sooner, or they might not have such an urgency to get back to work. We did this study in a multi-center cohort and found that patients that underwent non-operative treatment initially had significantly better pain and function. However, in the longer run, patients that received operative treatment did significantly better in terms of shoulder pain and function after treatment for rotator cuff tears. So this data actually informs practitioners to counsel their patients on a timeline for recovery after both operative and non-operative treatment, which in turn enables shared decision-making as well as informed decision-making, again, based on a patient's life situations as well as their need to return to work. Although this study provides very valuable data in this regard, the eventual answer to this question of operative versus non-operative treatment and a timeline for recovery can only be obtained from a randomized clinical trial. Thank you.